What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I am Nehemiah Wilson. Thank you for joining me here today. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button, turn your notifications on. It's the little bell so you can stay informed and get notifications when I drop a new video, because I don't know when that may be. And if you haven't already done so, slide on over to your favorite podcasting platform, search for the Puzzle Piece Media Podcast. Find me there and listen to more of what I got going on. Now that we got that out the way, I have to say something. I have to admit it. I don't want to. I am an elder millennial. I'm 38 years old. I have to say that our parents were right. They were. I know. It pains me to say it too, but our parents were right. We had no business whatsoever listening to the stuff that we were listening to, okay? We just didn't. We thought we was grown. We thought they was old and out of touch. But the fact is, we should not have been listening to the music that we was listening to when we grew up, when we was listening to it. Somebody had to say it. I said it. They was right. Listen to some of this stuff.
You ain't gotta say too much from the look in your eyes. I can tell you wanna fuck.
And you ain't gotta call me a boo. It's as bad as you wanna
fuck. No, you ain't got.
I was 14 years old when that song came out. 14. It came out 4 days exactly before my 15th birthday. Now, y'all can look back at yourselves at 14, 15 years old. Y'all can act like y'all knew what was going on. Me personally, I didn't. I had no business listening to this or singing this with my full chest like I knew anything about the look in anybody's eyes and what they wanted to do. Our parents was right. We had no business listening to the stuff that we was listening to. Now, this album came out when I was 12 years old. 12. I'd been on the earth for 12 years. Count them. This is the first rap album I ever bought. The very first one. My mom had finally relented. She's going to let me listen to some of this rap music. And she decided that if he's going to listen to it, I might as well know what he's listening to. He's going to do it anyway. And at the time, there was no hotter rappers or rap group than Master P and them No Limit Soldiers. So she takes me to the store. We go to the register. We pay for the CD. We get into the car and we put it in, and this is the very first thing that she heard through the speakers.
Make a substitute. Crack. For music. I mean, dope tapes. This how we would make.
That is
all the players hustlers rolled up. You smoke.
Make crack like this.
Ghetto dope. No Limit Records, part of the Tobacco
and Firearm crack like
and Freedom of Speech Committee.
Thank you, Dope Fiends, for your support.
Huh? I was 12. 12 years old, and the first lyrics are may crack like this? No. What was I thinking? Why did I think I was grown enough to be listening to music like this? The man literally in the verse gives you the recipe to cook crack cocaine. Our parents was right. They was right. We shouldn't have been listening to that. Now, I walked around singing this song at the age of 13 when it came out as if I had any connection and understanding and experience as to what this song was talking about. I can assure you, I didn't. I was pretending that I did. Oh, I pretended like I understood everything that was being said and pretended that I could have wrote the song myself, based on my experiences. Now, y'all can look back at yourself at 13 and say you wasn't pretending, but damn it, you was. And our parents was right. We had no
flop on my knob, like corn on the cob. Check in with me and do your job. Lay on the bed and give me head. Don't have to ask, don't have to beg. Juicy is my name.
Really? Really? That's what we was listening to at 13 and 14 years old, like we was grown? Come on now. Come on. Like I said, y'all can pretend that y'all understood it and knew about it, but I didn't. None whatsoever. No experience. No nothing. Our parents was right. We had no business listening to that mess. Now at the age of 15, I walked around and I sang this song with my entire chest, as they say. What little bass I could muster up in my voice, I sang this song. And looking back, I can realize that I shouldn't have been singing that song. It wasn't for me. It wasn't for you if you were roughly the same age. You could pretend it was, but it wasn't. Because looking back and listening to the song now, I can realize that at 38, having literally been around the world, I still have not done many of the things specifically mentioned in this here song. Our parents was right. This song wasn't for us at the time. At 15, we had no business listening to this. Y'all gonna sit here and pretend y'all knew about that at 15? I didn't. I was pretending I did. Pretended I had done all these things and was prepared to do the ones that I hadn't done, but no. Mm-mm. Our parents was right. That wasn't appropriate. And everybody talks about the rap music that we shouldn't have been listening to when we was listening to it at that age. But nobody really talks about the R&B, because it was the R&B too, okay? This one came out when I was 12 years old, and I sang it with my whole heart, and you probably did too if you're around the same age. And you sang it with your heart to the point that I'm not even going to play the song. I'm just going to sing it, even though I can't sing. You probably can't sing either, but it's just something about it. It's so ingrained in our DNA, even though it didn't apply to us, that still to this day, when you hear anybody say, it's 7 o'clock on the dot, I'm in my drop top, cruising the streets. What streets? Where was we cruising? In what drop top? We didn't have money. Cause the ability to drive? None of that. This song did not apply to us. It just didn't. I got a real pretty, pretty little thing that's waiting for me. Waiting where? Where was you going? You might have been meeting up at the skating rink or something. That was about it. I pull up. Anticipated good love, don't keep me waiting. Oh, we was gonna wait, cause we was 11, 12, 13 years old. We all still had some waiting to do at this point. Now, this the only part of the song that had some truth to it was, I got plans to put my hand in places I never seen, girl, you know what I mean. I mean, our parents was right. That wasn't for us.